In this Canva tutorial, you're gonna learn how to create this kind of beautiful Instagram puzzle feed for your own Instagram account or for your clients, whether you are a Canva free or Canva Pro user. We're also then gonna jump into another free online tool to split up your image into 9 individual graphics so you can then post them on Instagram, and then we'll jump into Instagram and actually post that together as well. You can follow along and create your own beautiful puzzle feed template, but if you just wanna copy mine, I have created a template for you that's in the description of this video, and with just one click, you'll be able to add it to your Canva design library and start creating straight away. So make sure to check that out there and let's get creating. So first of all, if you're looking for puzzle feed inspiration, there really is no better place to come to than Pinterest, because you'll find lots of boards and pins that have a lot of inspiration for you to pull from. These are images that you can then screenshot and put into your Canva design so that you can continuously refer back to them as you're designing if you're ever getting stuck for ideas of how to structure your puzzle feed. But for our purposes here, we're just going to head on over to Canva and create a custom design document, or you can just use the template I've given you in the description of this video, which is going to shortcut this for you, and you're going to start with your template already ready. But just so you understand how it's done, in case in the future you want to replicate this, all you're really doing is just creating a custom dimension template that is in multiples of 1080, because Instagram graphics are 1080 by 1080 pixels, so they're always going to be 3,240 pixels across, because there's only ever going to be 3 in a row, but this can be as long as you want it to be. So we're only going to be doing 3 by 3, so 3,240 by 3,240, because that's 3 1080p graphics in a row. But if you wanted to design more than 9 posts at a time, if you wanted to design 12, all you would do is just add 1080 to this and it would give you another row of 3. And then you also want to make sure that you know where your graphics are going to be sitting, because it can be really hard to know that. So under File, you want to go over to Show Rulers and Show Guides. Both of these need to be ticked in order for you to do this, or again, just use my template because I've already preset this for you. But effectively, all you're doing here is just dragging these lines down so that you can give yourself a bit of a guide as to where each of those 9 images is going to sit, so you don't place any weird overlapping text or anything like that. So each of those beautiful graphics is going to be a standalone graphic and it's going to be a part of this puzzle feed. So you want to make sure you're going over to 1080, and that's on the horizontal and vertical line as well. It's going to be 1080. And then the next line across is going to be at 2160, both vertically and horizontally, and so on and so forth. So it is a little bit tedious to get these to be exactly where you want them to be, and you often have to keep zooming in and out of your canvas to make sure that you're aligning it correctly, which is exactly why I've created the template for you guys, so it's really easy for you to just go ahead and start designing, but so you know how it's done in case you ever need to replicate this for clients or for yourself as well. But just so you know, these grid lines are not going to show up in your final design. They're just there to guide you so you know this is going to be one graphic, this is the next one, and so on and so forth. At any point while you're designing, if you just hit either this short keyboard shortcut or you just do that, so I'm just going to be using the shortcut, but you can just turn these on and off so you can see the design as a whole. So now I'm going to start placing a few elements in here and creating our graphic. But I did also want to mention that if you stay till the end of the tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can actually incorporate video graphics inside of your puzzle feed, which is a very advanced tactic. So if you're not comfortable with this step yet, that's totally fine. The rest of the tutorial is going to be relevant to you. I just want to show those of you who maybe are doing this as social media managers and you want to really, really ramp up your skill set, how you can incorporate video into this as well. So I'm just going to go in and drag a few templates in here by creating a new page. At this stage, I'm not worried about sizing them down. I'm just looking at some templates here that really inspire me that I could use for my design. All right, so I'm just going to keep on dragging a couple of different elements in here. Just really some elements from these designs that I want to just bring into my design. So I'm not going to be taking in all of them. But for example, like, I really like this frame for an image, so I would go ahead and just bring that in here. At the moment, I'm happy to just design with a white graphic background, just to make things a little bit easier. So I'm just going to speed up this part of the tutorial for you. Just know that occasionally if I want to grab two elements from a graphic, I would probably group that so that they can come together and they don't get out of whack. But essentially all I'm doing is either hitting Command C on my keyboard and then going back to the original design block and then Command V to paste that in. Or if you want to replicate certain parts of your design in different squares, you can hold down your Option key on your Mac and it'll essentially just drag a replicate version of that original graphic. But for my purposes, I'm just going to be copying and pasting from some of the templates that I find here. I'm just going to speed things up a little bit and then we'll chat about some different elements once I've brought a few things into this design. All right, guys, so at this stage, all I've really done is just brought in different elements from different graphics, and I could take a few more, but I'm happy with just keeping things relatively minimalistic for the time being. Now, two big things that you'll notice. One is that the images don't really look very cohesive and neither do the colors. In terms of the colors, if you don't have Canva Pro, you will have to just manually go through and update all the colors, which is fine. It just takes a little bit of time. If you're on Canva Pro, you will have your brand kit options. So if you haven't already, just go to your Canva home. You'll be able to go over to brand kit and you'll be able to set up brand colors. So I have a few different color palettes for my particular brand, which allow me to cycle through a few different things in the style section. All you'll be doing is just having a look at how this design might look with your brand colors in it. So I have a few different options. My black and my yellow are a little bit aggressive sometimes. So I have one that has no black, one that has no yellow, and this allows me to just cycle through a few different designs to see what might look right for my brand. And same with my oranges, which actually I think for this design, orange might actually look even nicer. And I'm just gonna have a look through and cycle through a few different options here. And maybe I'll take a look at what this looks like without the grid lines. That looks pretty good. So all I would do is just manually tidy up any last few elements because it's never gonna be 100% perfect. So you will always have to maybe go in and just play around with a few things. Some things might also have adjusted transparency as a part of the design file document there. So I'm just going to go ahead and tidy a few things up here. So I've gotten my colors to be a little bit more cohesive than they were before, which is a big win already. But now I want to do the same thing with my images. So I would head on over to elements and maybe pull through a couple of different images that might have the same sort of vibes and feel. So for me, for example, I would probably be going for something to do with working online, and I can then have a look at the magic recommendations to see what it's suggesting to me as related images. And I can just keep on placing these inside of these frames and they'll just snap into place because Canva is awesome like that. And again, I'm just gonna hit my shortcut to remove the grid lines to see how everything's looking. Now, keeping in mind that at this stage, these graphics over here actually have nothing on them. So I would wanna make sure I'm putting in some text. The reason I didn't do that as a part of my sped up tutorial part is because I wanna point out something that has been really helpful in my own content creation journey, which is to center align your text and then align it within the square that it's in, but then also use the anchor text in the middle, which means that if you're pasting in any other text into this, it's going to expand outwards evenly to the top and the bottom and obviously left and right because it's center aligned, which means it's not sort of messing with your design as you're doing this. So now if I was going to, let's say, put this text slightly smaller or slightly bigger, it's just going to keep expanding or shrinking, but all in the middle of my graphic, which is awesome. So I would just hold down my Option key or just copy and paste to get a bit of these kind of text boxes into my other squares here. and just make sure I've got something going on with all of them. That's looking good. And let's do one more up here. So I would probably have to shift this guy down a little bit so it's not overlapping with the text too much. Now you could then bring in some quotes just from here, so you can put in, you know, quotes or motivational quotes and have a look at what's available there, or you can bring in your own quotes. So just for our purposes here, I'm just gonna copy over a couple of these quotes here. That's looking pretty good. Now, keep in mind that these are going to be quite large. This text is going to be quite large. You'll be able to see it if you zoom all the way in to the graphic itself. So that's quite a lot of text. You may decide that you want it to be slightly smaller, so it doesn't have to be a huge large text, as long as it's still visible on a small screen. So always just sort of zoom in, and once we're going to be splitting the image up, you'll also be able to check it and then send it to your mobile device and make sure that it all looks good. Another quick little Canva hack for you, if you're ever doing this where I've just messed with the font size, what I can do is grab the paintbrush and then just copy that over to my other fonts here so that I can make sure everything is consistent. And I will just move this up to make sure that this text can then be fully covered by that graphic element, so that it all looks nice and part of my design. So I'm really happy with how that's turned out. And now all I would do is I would download this as a PNG file to make sure that it's really, really high in its quality. I would make sure I'm not compressing anything, and then just go ahead and download that. And the next thing we're gonna do is go and have a look at how to split this image up into 9 beautiful individual graphics. And then later on, I'm gonna show you how to turn one of them into a video using some of these animated elements like what we've got over here. But before we go ahead and do that, I just wanted to say, if there are other Canva tutorials you'd like me to create on this channel, I'd love to hear from you in the comments section below this video. So make sure to let me know your thoughts there. And now let's go ahead and start splitting our image. So now we're over on pinetools.com/split-image, and we're just gonna upload our beautiful image. I haven't named my file very well, obviously, but I'm just gonna select, I wanna split this as a grid. And I want to make 3 blocks vertically and 3 blocks horizontally. So now I can go ahead and split that. And now I can download this as a zip file or just individually one by one. Just to make it easier, I'm going to download it as a zip file. And we'll be using that later on Instagram. But for now, what I want to do is actually grab the image that's going to be this third one over here. So that's what we're going to be turning into a video. For those of you who want a little bit of an extra, more elaborate, fancy way of doing this. So just within Canva, what you would be doing is just creating a regular Instagram post. So it's just gonna be a 1080 by 1080p. And we're gonna bring in our image from our grid here. And I'm just gonna size that up. And now we're gonna bring in some sort of animated element. So I could say something like, let's just have a look at what's available as a white moving element. So I'm just gonna only look at animated elements here that I can bring in, but elements that will only affect this graphic here and none of my other graphics, because we don't wanna be creating video elements that would need to overlap with the other graphics in our design, because we don't have influence over them, because they all have to be individually posted. So one like this, for example, I think that looks pretty cool. I would just make sure I'm sizing that down. And now I'm gonna go ahead and download that as an MP4. Now, if I was gonna jump back into my original design here, I'm just gonna copy my canvas over so I'm not messing with the original. But what you'll notice if I was going to bring in my video clip here is that a video is never gonna look exactly the same as a flat image. It's always gonna have colors that are slightly different. And that can really throw off the whole look of your canvas. So sometimes I like to just bring this back in and have a look at how this will look in terms of the color comparison with the rest of my graphic, and also turn off my grid lines so I can have a look at how the color comparison stands up. So you'll notice there is a very, very slight tonal difference. So the way to overcome this is to place white elements or really light elements around the graphic that you want to turn into a video. That usually helps. Or alternatively, what I like to do is at the very end, all I do is grab the color picker, have a look at the actual video color, and then I update the actual document to match that. And same with any overlapping areas like this here, I would just grab where the actual video color is, and that way you can create a really seamless experience and the video will very, very seamlessly blend in, and inside of your feed it'll all look really nice and cohesive. All you have to do in this point is delete the video and just export this image again, cut it up again, and then you'll be able to post this in a way that it really color matches with the video. Yes, that's a bit of an advanced step, but if you do want to use video elements inside of your puzzle feed, don't be afraid to do so. It's a really, really cool way to impress the pants off your clients if you're doing this as a social media manager. It just has to be right for your brand in a way that you're able to change those background colors and it doesn't mess with your brand identity. So I'm just going to go ahead and download the second version now. I'm going to cut it all up and I'm going to put those images on my phone so we can jump into Instagram and have a look at how to post these. So now just over on Instagram on a demo account here that I just used to sort of test out these kind of things, I would just go over to create this post. Now this is the entire graphic. I have just saved it so that I have a bit of a reference point because I want to make sure I'm posting these in order of last to first, I guess, in a way. So the bottom right hand corner image goes first and then kind of snaking its way up all the way to the top left hand corner. So I need to grab this sort of computer blob here as my first post. I would want to make sure that I've got my captions ready to go with my hashtags and everything else. But in this case, I'm just doing this as a demo. So we can just go straight in and keep on posting these in the order, and then I'll just stop again once we get to the video post. So now we're heading to the top right hand corner, which is my video post. So I want to make sure I'm grabbing my video post instead of the static graphic. And I would just go through all of the same sort of things that I would have for the static post. And let's keep going. All right, and there it is. There's our beautiful puzzle feed. So you'll notice that each of the graphics individually looks really nice when it's coming across somebody's feed. It doesn't look out of place. It doesn't look like there's something missing, which can often be the case with puzzle feed images when they're broken down. Sometimes they look incomplete when they're standalone, which is why I like creating this kind of strategy where each graphic is a standalone beautiful graphic, but then together they play together really well like this. The only thing to keep in mind that we haven't really discussed is that with a video on your feed like this, you'll have the little play button in the upper right hand corner. So just making sure there's nothing that's important there for somebody to read, like a piece of text or something like that. So just being really aware of that. But if this comes across somebody's feed, it's really, really beautiful. And then when you're sharing this to your story as well, it'll autoplay, which is another little perk of sharing video content on your Instagram feed, not just static images. Thanks for watching today's training on how to create an Instagram puzzle feed with Canva. If you liked the video, I hope you'd give it a like and subscribe to the channel so you never miss a future training just like this one. Have a great day, guys, and I'll see you in the next video.